Last month sometime, you wrote a report. It had a pretty colorful title, sort of questioning the valuation on this company. Now that we've seen that the potential market assessment of what this company is going to be worth, do you think that even at $20 billion or $30 billion, that might be a little bit more of a reasonable thing to chew on rather than the $40 to $50 billion we thought that this might be valued at?
So good to be with you. I would argue this, in fact, is not a market assessment. This is me putting my Toyota Camry on the market for $1 million, and then when I get market feedback that that's not going to fly, I try and price it at $500,000. I ignore the initial valuation, quote unquote, at 45 to 50. This company is not worth 20 to 30. I mean, look at comparables here. This company invests long and then arbs the short-term rental, similar to Hertz, similar to a direct competitor, IWG, that traded 0.5 to 1.5 times revenue. So at $20 billion, this makes no sense. And that's why, and I love predictions, I don't think this thing gets out. I don't think it's anywhere near $20 billion. So the fact that it's been cut in half doesn't matter.
You know, we've obviously seen several IPOs this year. Many of them haven't done well, but they got out the door despite investor concerns about the fundamental unit economics of the business. And of course, Uber is chief among them. How much of the fact that there are so many concerns is about the business of what you describe, these long-term obligations and renting them out short-term? And how much is the concern just about every other red flag that everyone immediately saw when they read that S-1?
Well, I think the answer is yes. You have a company where the individual who supposedly knows the most about the company has become one of the 1,000 wealthiest people in America by selling $700 million, trying to go on a roadshow convincing other people to buy shares that he can't sell fast enough. You have a company that's trading at, even with this revised valuation, would be going out at 12 to 14 times revenues versus Amazon at 4, or even you mentioned Uber. Uber is the cautionary tale here. Uber did manage to get out and has declined substantially, and it trades at 5 times revenues and is teaching the marketplace that if a company doesn't make sense, it's usually not a good stock to own. So neither of these companies, neither Uber nor WeWork in their current structure make any economic sense as standalone companies. They just don't work.